Dear friends, this is the liquidation experience and part 3 of my video. Here I am going to give you a very important sections dealing with them. Section 43, 45 and then 49 and 66. I am more focused into how we should plead before the Honorable Adjudicating Authority, and more like a live experience I would like to share it with you, because I was only appearing in that case with some small assistance. I will prepare everything, petitions and all, and I was very fortunate because that bench's judicial member is Honorable Prakash Kumar. Now he is the president of the NCLT, a wonderful judge, and his knowledge is extraordinarily good, and he is very fast in understanding the case and disposing the case also. He will give you opportunity to listen, but you have to go well prepared, because the first point most advocates, youngers, big people know better than us, and the youngsters must realize that when you are going before the Honorable Adjudicating Authority, you have to prepare yourself. You have to prepare. So you have to, as I told you, prepare yourself about the issue. So far as the adjudicating authority, the bench is concerned, NCLT, any bench, the learned judges are extremely technically qualified. If you take Honorable Prakash Kumar J, he is supported by Honorable Vijay Raghavan. Technically, he is very sound. And Honorable Prakash Kumar is very good in the law, company law, any law for that matter, his fingertips is keeping. And his ability to understand this environment very fast and disposal of the issues, highly experienced judge. So, all that they need is facts. If you are able to correctly establish the facts with evidence, because NCLT proceedings are summary proceedings. There is no room for inquiry. You have to present it an information which is perfect, and then they will, once you argue, they will decide about the fate of the case, and they will ask for a counter, then you give rejoinder to the counter, matter is disposed of. And I've been appearing for the last 12 years before the Honorable Madras High Court as a party in person, because I'm a chartered accountant in practice. What I learned there is, because I was fortunate, most of my cases were high profile cases. Hence, advocate generals were the respondents' advocates. I used to learn from them how they are approaching. And the courts, honorable judges, high court judges are interpretative of law. Law is interpreted. Because when you are going before the honorable high court judge, he may be comfortable in the subject, may not be comfortable, because it's a vast syllabus, because it's a writ jurisdiction. So you have to tell them the complete facts in a short span of time and then convince the judge with a lot of research. I've seen Honorable good judges, division bench, they appreciate your hard work. They're ready for going for arguments. When it comes to NCLT, I repeat, the judge is knowing the subject very well. The law, everything, you go and say Section 343 says this and all. The learned judge would have already passed so many orders. So therefore, you don't try to show too much knowledge in these sections. And then see that facts in your hand are perfect. And then you have to convince them with the evidence. And then you be prepared with the opponent advocate, what are the issues you are raising. You please be very, very clear. And another point is, you can see, the judges are very intelligent, then no problem. But then the NCLT is a economic legislation. Huge money is involved. The person engaging you as an advocate, it doesn't matter. He has to get 100 crores. If you are able to get him money, he'll pay you 2 crores, 3 crores. That is why the charges are very, very exorbitant. And you have to win the case. Big, big advocates will come. And then many situations are such that you may not get justice. Your case may be very good, but on some grounds it will be knocked off. Then you have to be prepared to go to NCLT, which is in Delhi. And then here, when you go to the next level of NCLT, then Mukhopadhyay J was ruling the fort for about 5 years, 3 years, full time was there. He's a Supreme Court judge, because of which their lordships will be more interested on interpretation. Several judgments he passed, sweeping conclusions he came to, and they all were turned down by Supreme Court. That was very unfortunate. But then he was interpreting his, it's NCLT, if you see, principal bench in Delhi, very small room, and big people like Kapil Sibal, Abhishek Singh, we charging 50 lakhs for hearing, they appear. And so he has got 100, 200 cases throughout India coming, and he'll be adjudicating 2-3 hours, 180 minutes, 30 cases, 6 minutes per case. So that approach will be totally different. And so when you prepare a case, you have to decide how do you go about it. And here I am only a liquidator, 14 person. And the problem is that when you want to go to a big lawyer, you spend a lot of time with him. And then you have to tell all the facts there. So I was appearing for myself because I wanted to learn and then practice myself. And I'm really fortunate, honorable, it's a learning experience. And I'm ever grateful to his knowledge. And perfect, he doesn't bother. And if you are on the point, he will give you relief. So this is a facts of the case, let me put it to you. The same case which we are talking about. This gentleman, the promoter, it's a 7-floor building, full 7 floors, household items will be there. Boring business. The location is such, per day 3 lakh footfalls will be there, that road. And these people are 100-year-old brand. So people are accustomed to buying all this auspicious thing, means they will go. Then these gentlemen, when the brand name is established, people, small scale industries, they will manufacture all these items. And then they will submit, they will give the goods. He will repay them, pay them after 3 months. His employees, staff are from his native place, so highly committed loyalists. Oh, this is the bank. And they are doing extremely well. High profits. So, and naturally, bankers will support a person doing so well. And many times they would like to ask him to take money. And as the business goes on, what happens? Some problems do come in there. Family problems will be there. Something will be there. Many business houses, if you see, business one will be doing very well. Then they will enter into some other unknown territory, promising to earn crores of rupees. The result will be both will be wiped out. So, here also something like that must have happened. So, when he senses there is a problem that he has borrowed huge money from the banks, and he started his own another 2 outlets as a backup. And they named them same name, but partnership firm they used to call, because this is a company. So he is well prepared 1-2 years before the CIRP process. And when the CIRP process started, everybody told him that this can be used. CIRP is a very good legislation, which you can use it to come out. Your loan is 100 crores of rupees. Then you pay some 5 crores, give some proposal, and then you can say, I will repay. Bankers will agree. So therefore, the legislation, when they said recovery is not the objective, resolution like that, all the NCLAT, IBC, NCL, all that they said. But actually, what is the, why bankers are filing case? Bankers are filing case to recover their money. But we don't know why they were mentioning that these people really realize. So if objective is you want 100 crores back, but let that not be sold in pieces, plant and machinery like that, use. Better somebody, you find out somebody to whom you can sell it as a going concern. He will take your employees, machinery, everything. And he will continue the business. It's like just running company. Managing directors change. That was the. But that doesn't mean that somebody will come for 1 rupee and you give a 100 crore company. But that has happened. Today, we lost 6,50,000 crores. That is, I think, settled because IBBI did not refute. There is no papers everybody have written. So obviously, if it is wrong, they should have countered it. They have not countered it. And then they were only talking, as we have discussed earlier. Now we will come. Liquidation means it is accepted that you get zero. Very rarely you get some money, which may not be equivalent to recovery of the liquidation expenses. If you take ILFS, you can see that about 100 crores they have spent till now only on the fees payable to consultants. So, yes, anyway, we'll proceed. It's a good economic legislation if it has been implemented properly. And there is nothing wrong, we can do it in future based on the experiences gained. But they have to fix accountability. They have to fix accountability on the top persons. What are you doing? You're giving us impression of doing well. But what are the results on the ground? Right. So I've talked about law. So whenever you go to an adjudicating authority, we remember that the facts should be perfect. Because most cases that you are going to file petitions are already told in the law clearly. And they have not followed it, that's all. But only in case of 43, 45, 43 to 66. Very, very important sections. These are very important sections. Because, as you see, when this promoter realized that he is going to be out, and he also realized that this legislation, we can use it to earn, get back. That is 100 crores loan. Finally, you pay 20 crores and come out. 80 crores you save. Then who doesn't want like that? And you are safe. All the litigations, everything will get out of you. And income tax dues, everything will be out. They will be removed. I mean, you need the liability. If you are going through a CIRP process, then you are settled once for all. So, this discussion has already taken place. What is the role of personal guarantees in the case of CIRP? What is the role of personal guarantee in case of liquidation? Liquidation, the promoters continue to remain liable for this thing, personal guarantees. So, section 43 to 50, that is 66. The preferential transactions, undervalued transactions, fraudulent transactions. But that is the promoter is, everybody does it. He will prepare for the troubles. He understands. Whenever you anticipate troubles are coming, first thing you realize is how to protect yourself, your family, your business. So, then the consultants, everybody will be called and you will be preparing for it. One of the ways in which preference is you have an asset worth 10 crores, to give it to your relatives for 1 crore. That's all. Then adjustments will take place. And ours is a cash carry economy. And next step is you get try to give creditors on it. If it is liquidation, there is an order of payment. And you being, suppose I am a big rowdy fellow, I am the third list of priority. So money comes first, I'll have to pay X. Well, then whatever is available, Y. Then Z. But now suppose I want, this man is threatening me. So I would like to make him one. That is called as preferential creditors. Giving preference. Making the arrangement in such a way. Then related parties, you try to deal with them. And all these things. Then fraudulent means you divert all the funds to sister companies and you keep running the business in the detrimental interest of the creditors. So the Honorable Supreme Court gave a judgment, and on this 43 Fidendal, as you know, NCLT Ahmedabad, NCLAT dismissed that decision, and Supreme Court upheld NCLT judgment and then dismissed what NCLAT is. Very well analyzed. But I'm not going to the law. I have to take you to the practical wisdom. All right. So, the case is like this. This gentleman was having stocks throughout 7 floors. He was hoping that he will find some solution. Even liquidation, you can sell it as a going concern. Regulation 32E is there. We were also pursuing with him to settle these things, why you unnecessarily fight with you and all that. So first process is always conciliation. And as you told, I mean, I have explained all that. We filed a petition. First, what we filed is, he's not providing us any books of accounts. Once the order came, he diverted all the stocks. Stocks worth 79 crores of rupees, which was submitted in 2013 to the banks. Signed. So that's the only thing is there. Whereas we are in 2019. So 2018 is liquidation. We have to establish that he comes under this, but that means we need books of accounts. Bank accounts are not there. And then, so already we got an order from the Honorable Adjudicating Authority to give us protection, police protection to vacate him, which we could do it. Books of accounts and other documents he was not supplying, assistance. So you can't just rush to Adjudicating Authority for everything. So you have to do some things because it is driven by principles of natural justice. Therefore, we called for a meeting of the stakeholders and asked him, who has the books of accounts? And this is your mandatory, you are supposed to give. Followed it up with the email and all, but he was not, well, he is reluctant. And so we have moved the case. What case, what is the petition I moved for? Punish him for contempt. Because at that point in time, IBBI sent one big certificate like thing. I think everybody, RPs would have got it. Mr. Kavdia, general manager, he said that in case anybody is not hindering your resolution process or liquidation process, not obeying the orders of the court, you can file a case for contempt of court. And then they are citing that Shivam water supplies. That was the case decided. Then we also came to know Madras High Court has two benches, bench 1. Bench 1 is a single judge. Ms. Honorable Tariq sits, judicial member only. And he actually many promoters, when they did not come, he called them and told them they will get arrested. And in one case, he asked the promoter to sit down till the dawn of the court. Like how high courts do. He did. Then that had a good effect. And this is the law. So we thought we will, we also threatened that fellow. He was get scared, but then lawyers, he will also have lawyers. Not so soon. Second thing I realized, you should keep the hostile stakeholders busy by filing case. You should not leave them just like that. And they will file case against you. They can hinder the entire process. So then 43 is always there for everybody. You have to take a view on that. And you have to follow that all the provisions, giving him an opportunity of being heard and come. When you are fighting a case of this magnitude, and when the promoter believes he has a good case to get out of it and cheat all the banks, then naturally he won't mind. He's getting 100 crores liability cleared. So why should he not pay the advocate who gets it up on 2-3 crores? So I put the case. Petition came up for hearing. And they appointed advocate general, additional advocate, visa, and told he paid a lot of money, 3 lakhs per hearing. It's very low, I believe, in Chennai. Sorry, okay. I only appearing for myself. Because we don't have any money. Unless we sell the asset, we won't get anything. And the expenses paid by the bankers, they were kind enough to pay. That will be sufficient to give advertisements, e-platform sales, those things only. Professionals also, IPPA is not clear. You should not appoint and you should do this. What can you do alone? And it's very important that it's a great effort involved. And this is a massive work. Small works. There are so many such works. But what happens, and as I repeated telling, ICBBI, most of them are officials of the government sitting there, retired bank managers are transferred from banks. So they will not be knowing. It is not a process just like that. You can call the phone and then get things done. If they don't do it, you file the case, immediately court will fire them. It's not there. Indians are well-trained guys. They know to manage anything and frustrate your efforts. Therefore, you need extra tricks to deal with the situation. You should be able to win the adjudicating authority's confidence that you are an honest person. Lot of issues are there. These people don't know. And for all that hard work, nothing will be paid. That is also another problem. And that is anyway we discussed in our previous audios. Now, right, we moved. What is the petition prayer? This man is not obeying your order. This is the order specifically given. See, in case of a contempt, if it is a contempt petition in the Madras High Courts, contempt jurisdiction is a very restricted jurisdiction. And you have to exactly explain that. And you have to see that order is against X. So only X is subject to contempt. Clearly the order should have been passed by the court asking the person to do or not to do something. Yes. Again then, you are the person against which relief is sought. So you have done your efforts. To establish that is a willful default. Intentional disobedience to the order of the court. Then only you will have a start. So that is very, very important. You have done all the background. And we came. So when the matter came up, what's the matter? Honorable Prakash Kumar asked. I said, Lord, you passed the order and you are very kind and we got the custody. We are in the full swing to realize. I hope I will get maximum realization to the yes. Oh, very good. And next, then why are you here? My Lord, sir, is not. I find that the stock statement show about 73 crore stock was there. But now they left me only 10 lakhs second-hand stock after my valuations. They followed due process. Now I want some books of accounts to establish how that 71 crores has become 10 lakhs. You should have declared losses, something is telling. And the books of accounts are not there. We tried all these things. Then he said, Shukumar, you asked for contempt. I will dismiss this petition. I was surprised. My lords, what is this, my lords? That, I showed IBBA, this Kavadia, this thing. Just looked at it and keep it there. Now, I said, the first bench has passed all that. He asked me, Shivakumar, please note, this contempt jurisdiction is available for courts of records. Court of record is High Court and Supreme Court. You agree, no? You are a constitutional lawyer, so I don't need to tell you. Then how do you say they are court of record? You go to Constitution. You take Article 215. It gives power to High Court to exercise contempt jurisdiction. And 129 article, if you see, Supreme Court will give. Now you show me some article which empowers this thing. Then I will agree. Okay. Since you are showing this and that and this thing, I have to go by Constitution. This is only a tribunal. Tribunal is not even a court. They are governed by principles of natural justice. You know that. How that Article 324A, B is there. Now you are asking me to bring him to the court and punish him for contempt for which I don't have any powers. So I am dismissing this. But it's clear. Then, I basically will not argue further because the knowledge of the judge is so much. My law knowledge is very limited and they are going to learn. So I said, okay, my laws, but then you pass orders and they don't trust, they don't obey, then what is the purpose of all this? Again, he said, you see, these tribunals have to function under legally. Lexi, not equity. Equity, you say this is nice, this is good. We are not willing to give it. The Supreme Court has already said so many times. So bring the law which empowers these facts and connect it with the law. I am ready to pass. Then he said, okay, Shukumar, you go and say Section 4, Companies Act 424. And I said, that is not a remedy at all, my lord. Civil procedure, you have to follow. And the time bound resolution and liquidation is completed. And then I will end up in only doing this litigation. I have to use this litigation to recover the money. That is what I am trying. My lord, sir, you please permit me to file Section 43. I'll come to that. I said, okay. I'm withdrawing these cases. That's all disposed. Here, most importantly, most of the advocates do is to please their client. They go on arguing. And how far this will be correct, I don't know. Because the learned judges are all judges. Of course, Prakash sir is extraordinarily brilliant. But I've seen Mumbai, I had an opportunity to appear before Nallu, Nalla Senapati ji. Very good, very good. And then in Gujarat, Bhave sir, Dharja, was also very good. And so I had a very good experience, knowledgeable judges. And they are very, very kind. Very kind and they listen to you. It was very pleasing. experience for me. And in this venture too, I must have appeared on 100 petitions. And almost all the, we are able to win. But I learned that tricks of presentation, short presentation, crisp, which we will talk slowly as and when we move. So I want to put both together, the practical experience, and also legal position. And okay, then we immediately filed 43. 2013 petition, this talk is not there. Talk audit report signed by him. All that I have is he was in control of the business till the 2018 December. At CARP process, ownership is still with him, but we could not take control. And it was me also, 4 months they did not give control. Then business is continued. So that point is established. And he has got a stock of 70 crores, 79 crores, but 10 lakhs is. So what has happened? He's having books of accounts, he's not cooperating. And stock given, he himself signed, and those proof is there. We took a proper procedure, we followed. So I, these are the facts I have, nothing else. I'm not able to get the records. And then we filed that. Then what I did is, I've been watching their lordships adjudicating in many cases. Most people, 43, the sections are, every liquidator comes there on this. So in that one case, the judge was telling some other senior advocate, see so-and-so, this is almost 1 year. We did not, this bench did not pass favorable order against this 4966. So be clear. Now you're coming as a thing, I need a full establishment that beyond all reasonable doubts, no presumptions, it's a criminal proceeding. So be clear, whoever is that, he was all, he saw me sitting there, so he has made it clear that then I prepared a 66 because 2013 and I don't have 2 years spec period is there. So there I don't, this is 2017 it was admitted. Naturally I can't, once he sees that he will dismiss. So I moved the petition under section 49 and 66. And my case is, as I already explained you, with that facts, I moved background what happened to this case. And then my strong point is that unassailable fact was that there is a stock declared and signed by the owner, proprietor, promoter for 79 crores, 79 crores. And he himself confirmed that he has given, handed over the RP has valued the stock for 10 crores or something. And he was in control of the business, and so these are all the facts which are relevant for the section 66. And then when we moved the case, then the other side they came, they took time, additional advocate general. Then they filed the counter. The counter they stand was that the company, they was doing very well, but rain came. 2015. As a result of the rain entering into the building, 7 floors building, and it is around 40,000 square feet roughly. And as a result of that sludge and all coming inside, the stocks, all that household items, grinders, some of them, all of them spoiled, many of them, you know, flooded. In the flood, they have gone washed. That was their stand one. Second is they were conducting that insurance survey. They produced unwritten, unsigned surveyor's report. And they wanted an argument on that. And when I was listening to Honorable Prakash Kumar sir, the facts are there with me, but I felt that they are beyond the, I'll not be able to establish that they're, that is end to end, I have to establish. Beyond all reasonable doubts, because a criminal proceeding. Criminal proceeding, NCLT will, I take a decision, a call. NCLT must believe that there is a criminal fraudulent transaction has taken place. That means I must be able to establish where the money is, stocks have been diverted to. So patches are there in my, and there are no books of accounts. And in that hearing, they took that stand that one is water came and destroyed. Books are also spoiled. And whatever available computers were given to the liquidator, therefore, we are not in a position to produce books of accounts also. And we could have taken from the GST records and the income tax records. They are all provisionals. We had that thing. And so end to end, I have to establish. But I am not having any records. And the other side is additional advocate general. So obviously the case is very strong. And the case started. So I said, fact number one, the stock is there. Fact number two, they themselves have declared the stock is there to the extent of 29 crore. But then it is in 2013. So I'm not able to use 43 or 45. And now they were in custody of the business. Their business is doing very well. Till the last, he asked me which is the date. That is up to 11th December 2018. Then the register, that valuation shows only 10 lakhs. That means stock has come down from 79 to 10 lakhs. And meanwhile, they took a stand that they have given it to the RP, which you admitted that much stock is there to the extent of 10. I said, okay, 10 crores is there, 10 lakhs has become. So that differential amount amounts to a fraudulent transaction. And they were doing roaring business. I had photographs taken. So I should. Then Judge told me, ki, hey, you are a chartered accountant. And I need some more data. I don't think I will. Because you should be able to establish where did they divert that stock. And how the stock has come down. And he says that water has come in. I want you to do some more work. I was for hearings. Adjourned. Then we thought we'll conduct a forensic audit. But records are not there. Then the computer was there. They left out of the computer. So we thought if you take the madam told me that, and another private bank, they all said, well, why don't we try from the hard disk? Then superimpose that, we will be able to get some data if it is there. And then we did it. We appointed, and there they had maintained perfect accounts. Yes, balance sheet was prepared. Wherein there is intercompany, sister company transactions all round. Around 75 crores worth of stock is receivables. Stock was only 19 crores and the balance is intercompany, they're shifting. So I had that to establish that he's rotating the stock in between the sister firms. And this is the stock he's having as per based. Then they took the stand that they wanted to bring in the insurance surveyors, and then they put it, you please issue notice to the insurance surveyor so that we can take up the matter further as per the Evidence Act. And the next hearing was there. I requested one of our friends to go and because I thought we will close, the case will be over. But then arguments went on, making sure that we have to produce a cross-examine that insurance surveyor call him. So when the hearing next came, then they started ready. I said, my lords, I have argued my case. Oh, this is what I want. The section 66, 49. All ingredients are established. Mine is an open and shut case. So that I have explained to your lordships that business was continued by him till the last one. Stock was there, and this is the balance sheet forensic audit clearly establishes. Let them dispute that. And they have not done. And I am finished with this. Then they had said, orders reserved. And when the orders reserved, the COVID, the lordship got become the president of NCLT. The order is reserved, and we have to wait once the COVID opens, what will be the order. The year, this is very, very important to us because this gentleman mortgaged another property is owned by him, an individual, the banks. If we get a favorable order, we can immediately move to recover it because there is a Bombay NCLT is there. In Bombay NCLT, Sharawat, he passed beautiful order. He said that when bankers are taking money, lending money, they are taking assets for the companies. They are pledging the assets of the company, mortgaging them. And they also, they are personal guarantee. So it should be looked together. Both of them should be looked together. And therefore, when this man defaults, we cannot see them separately. That was one stand is taken. In bankruptcy proceedings last December 1st, 2019, I think it's come. There, but then you can see IBBA how they are passing legislation. It didn't take off that, I don't know. Bankruptcy proceedings, how it starts. As good as this one, you have to initiate this action against him. And then claims you call this, that. But they have put a condition that the RP of the corporate debtor or liquidator has got some vested interest, so he should not be taken. So another person should come. Actually, the comfort level is the time-bound resolution if not achieved. The RP will be in a better position to know everything about the promoters because he's been dealing with them for 2 years. 3 years. That is, what is the problem with IBBA? The government is supporting them with full support, courts are supporting. Then they are passing all these such laws. Money is lost. First of all, these bankruptcy proceedings were simultaneously introduced at that time. Things would have been better, everybody would have paid. Now we have lost all the money. Then where, from where you will get it? And already COVID came, the economy is in trouble. And we have to only wait and see. So that is the